Oh. Somebody, please send help. Coach Pat's trying to kill me.
Bye-bye.
Help Kim.
Love you.
Love you, bye. She doesn't care. Whoa. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take out my frustrations on something today.
So as you saw, way over there, we've rebuilt a bunch of bikes. You might have noticed that the old Cervelo has one zip wheel and one non-zip wheel. The non-zip wheel used to be this. When I went to go and put this thing together to sell it, I actually found that there were two separate cracks in the wall of this wheel, so essentially it's garbage.
And I know how much you all hated me for taking this thing apart, but you should know that it really didn't work very well, just like this doesn't work very well. So instead of throwing it in the garbage, we do something with it. Like today, I want to know what's inside a rear hub. Let's rip it apart after I piece my life back together. Oh.
That is going down. But first, safety. All right, I got my sciency coat, I got my safety glasses, I got my steel-toed boots, I got... How do you think we do this, Mel? Lengthwise or widthwise? How do I cut it?
What do you want to see?
I don't really know what's inside. Just so everyone knows how safe we are, you want to show them your safety goggles?
Sunglasses.
So safe. All right, let's fire this baby up. Butter! I have learned nothing from this. Ow, ow, ow!
Except that it gets really hot.
Except that it gets really hot. So there's some sort of like, there's a piston inside the hub. It's like the outer casing, inner casing, and then, oh, well the piston is the skewer. Ah, which is really hot!
Gloves might be something to invest in for these.
Gloves. Oh, we have gloves. I want to see where the bearings are. Where are all the bearings in this? What's the thing that makes it go? You want to cut some more? I want to cut some more. That there. I want to know what's in that. Let's give that a shot that way. I could really use a vice grip right now. What's that smell?
That's what I was wondering.
Is that rubber? Steel.
What are all the...
melted. It's all melted. Ooh, maybe I don't take the gloves off. Okay, so that goes there. This goes in there. That is there. The skewer goes all the way through. It's a tight fit there. Okay. So that's like the main axle, and then it spins around that. There. I can't see what's in the middle. You know what this means? It's gotta go in half too. I don't know about you, Mel, but I am learning nothing. This is not educational whatsoever. Basically just an idiot playing with power tools. Yeah.
I have completely lost track of what's what. Besides, I know that that is a melted clamp. So I'm gonna be totally honest. I am shocked at how few parts there is. This is like the simplest thing ever.
What else did you think was gonna be in there?
I thought there was gonna be bearings, sprockets. I don't know what a sprocket is, but I thought there would be one. So it's basically just like a whole bunch of casings, and that holds.
Come on over.
So the red thing holds the cassette on. That's the one side. And then the other side, spokes. That is really just an exit point for the skewer. And the thing that spins on the inside is just a really tightly fitting shaft. I said shaft. So this shaft is what's in the inside spinning. And the reason that it spins in, I think that's where the bearing is. But it's not really ball bearings. It's just a bearing that spins. And there was that on the other side before we destroyed it. Oh, hey, there's a bearing.
There you go.
There we go. There, there's the other bearing. So you got one on one side, one on the other. It goes through. And on the other side, it would have gone into this. And that is what allows the wheel to spin.
Do you feel smarter?
Yeah.
I feel dumber. I don't think I learned a thing. It was really just an excuse to make a bunch of sparks. If you aren't yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button below. If you want to see more videos of idiots pulling apart triathlon things, hit that over there. And I'm sorry to subject you to all this. It otherwise would have gone in the garbage, and might as well put on my science-y coat and safety goggles and try to learn a thing or two. That's all. Keep those safety goggles handy, Mel.